Welcome back to Timișoara, Romania. If you missed our last video, we got our first impressions of this stunning city. We enjoyed all of the beautiful architecture, ate some delicious food and yummy desserts, and we met some very lovely people.
That's perfect, thank you.
After we got off the train, we were walking around the city, getting our first impressions. Tommy was doing his thing, getting B-roll of the city and
beautiful.
The people.
Thank you so much, have a good day.
And we met this really nice woman named Christina and her daughter Anna, and they actually invited us to their house today for lunch, you guys. So the Romanian hospitality keeps on giving to us this trip. So we're actually heading to their house for lunch right now.
So Christina was already bragging about her husband's cooking. I am super psyched. We are traveling a lot, we eat out a lot, no complaints. The food here in Romania has been amazing, but you do miss a good home-cooked meal. We brought some local Romanian wine to bring. We couldn't show up empty-handed.
It's like a very nice neighborhood, doesn't it? What are we having for lunch?
It's called chaun here in Romania.
Okay, cool.
Awesome.
I'm excited.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for the invite. I really appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Yeah, my husband is already setting things in motion.
I'm excited.
Perfect. Yeah, we're excited. Thanks for having us.
Yeah. We're gonna have some fun today.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Sammy.
Hi, I'm Andres. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too,
how are you?
Sir.
Do you do most of your cooking here?
Yes, we do most of the cooking we do here. What I'm planning to cook today is like a stew. This is more a Hungarian dish, but it's quite common here because we used to be under Hungarian, Austro-Hungarian occupation for quite a long time. So it's called goulash, right? It's like pork.
It's one of her favorites.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I love it.
So I have a recipe that we actually like very much. You can do it with beef also. I don't know if you do it with beef, but I prefer pork because it's a bit faster.
Okay, sweet.
What would you like to drink? I got some traditional Romanian drink.
Oh, we gotta try that?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's called tsuica, usually made from fruits like plums, apples.
Sweet.
Do you usually have it before then?
Yes, this is like an appetizer, right?
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Oh shucks, we have to try that too.
It's homemade 100%.
Oh, is it?
Yes. Welcome, guys.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Guys. You guys are so sweet.
Not wrong.
Oh, you learned that. Very well. See, not that strong.
Oh, wow.
Oh yeah.
Fruitful a bit.
Mm.
Mm.
It's very strong for me.
It is. All right.
Yes, for me as well.
Great flavor, though.
The sweetness.
Pretty smooth.
Yeah, I love the flavor.
Yeah.
Wow.
There
you
go.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Cheers, then.
Norok.
Norok. The process is here. Peeling off two onions, first of all. And then we are going to use some of this smoked bacon. This is bought from a local store.
Wow, it looks so good.
And the flavor is... Smell it. Mm. Two important ingredients is this one, this smoked bacon.
Uh-huh.
And this... I don't know how to translate this. Christina.
Caraway, yeah.
We use a bit of pork fat, and we have to fry this and this together so it can get a bit of flavor, and then we put the rest in it, but you'll see.
Okay, so caraway is the secret ingredient.
Yeah,
those
these two are the ingredients that will take our dish to the next level, right?
Sweet. I love it.
If you want to cook a great meal, you have to use a lot of onion.
Oh yeah, that really enhances all the flavors, I feel like.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We have a neighbor, which is... He is so friendly. Oh. And we were walking the dogs together. That's how we met him. Uh-huh. And he's cooking in a restaurant, which is 45 minutes drive from here.
Okay.
And he just got us some food.
Really?
That's so sweet.
Let's see what he brought.
Yeah. A nice just, neighbor to have.
Yes, we're helping each other. He helped Andre with raising those stuff when we had to put them in place.
Yeah.
They are really heavy lifting.
Yeah.
And he came with some friends. And
oh, wow. Nice.
You know, yes. Wow. Such a good neighbor.
Excellent neighbor.
Have.
Brings food and helps with the heavy lifting.
Speaking of Romanian hospitality, so why do you guys think that Romanians are so friendly?
Like, what made you invite us over to your house? You know what I mean?
I was telling Andre, it was such an interesting experience we had with you because, as I told you, I was talking to Anna about how she wants to study in the US, to go to university. It's all this, you know, about the Ivy League. And then at the traffic lights, you just made that comment about my dress and we started to talk.
Yeah.
And it seemed natural. for me to invite you to come over so you can see a Romanian, truly an authentic Romanian.
So sweet, seriously.
Like kismet, you know, when it just like happens.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. That's so sweet.
Yeah. The universe somehow worked.
Exactly. Yeah.
But overall, why do you guys think Romanians are so friendly?
No, I think it's quite normal. I mean, for us, you know, if you go, for example, if you go in the countryside, if you go in a village, right? People will ask you to come over for a drink, saying, sorry, I don't. They will ask you, why you don't drink? Are you ill? No, I'm driving. it's like a must. Come on.
Yeah.
You have to do that. You have to sit down. You have to eat. You have to, and they will put everything on the table for you because they want to. Obviously, this is something that happens in the villages and so.
Exactly.
Not too much in the city because obviously, when life is tough, then it's a bit maybe a different perspective. However, I think, and for us particularly, we do like to meet people and to talk and meet.
Exactly.
We were wondering actually about you guys. So we meet these people we never met before, and they somehow have the courage to come to the place of someone they don't know in a totally different country. It's a different, different space.
Well, come on, your energy, you're so friendly. There was no worry.
There was no reservations or anything like that. But it's just interesting because this is our second time in Romania. The first time we were here, we had we were invited to somebody else's house, and we with the two daughters and the mom and the dad, and we like were at their house like having drinks and doing like little shots and all of that kind of thing. And then we've traveled to many other countries, and then coming back to Romania, this is the second time we've been invited to somebody's house, twice in Romania.
The universe telling you have to come to Romania.
Yeah.
This is the place where you have the full experience. Right? How come you came the second time in Romania? Because it's not like, wow, what a place, why did you come again?
We had such a great time. There were so many places we hadn't been to, so we decided to come back and just explore it a bit more.
The real reason we came back is because the people were seriously amazing.
Yeah, we just love it.
Like you guys, invited us over to your house, never met us, cooking a beautiful dinner.
This is the best experience, you know?
Yeah, it is.
Cheers.
Oh, Noroc.
Cheers.
Noroc.
Noroc. Welcome.
Noroc. No, that's fine. I mean, in Romania, you can find quite nice wines, I believe. But you know, good food always takes time.
Ain't that the truth?
I like the sound.
Me too.
The magic.
The secret.
The secret magic one.
Next time you're in Romania, we must go
camping together. This is the kind of camping I want in my life.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that looks good.
Onions. Here. Add a bit of redness in the food, right? So the carrots will have to get acquainted with the meat. Yes, and colors.
I love how that.
Homemade tomato pasta. And this is homemade tomato ketchup.
Oh,
I'm going to put some of this. No, because take 23, I believe it is, right?
You're clever.
Just kidding. I bought a bread today for you guys to try. It's a local store here. Obviously, we have everything from the local store, right?
This is a
white bread. As Christina said, the US bread is very, very sweet.
Yeah, very sugary.
Very sugary. Most of your food is quite sugary. They tend to put a lot of sugar in it.
Yeah.
At least that was my experience from my travels over there.
Oh, dear.
Great.
You know, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Look how it looks like in the inside.
Wow, it smells amazing.
We do have another ingredient that we will add towards the end. If you add a bit of garlic in the goulash at the end, it gives such a good flavor. I personally love garlic. In Hungary, if you go, they will never put garlic in goulash.
Huh.
Garlic.
Exactly. I don't know why, but it's their, right, their way of doing it. Now it's time to add some water and leave it to cook. Yeah. I'm gonna make the fire a bit slower, put the lid on top of it, and that's it. So we are peeling off some potatoes now. They have to be boiled, very well cooked, but not overcooked. because then they will just lose themselves into our dish.
So they were just telling us that they go and get their water. They go get their water from a spring. They bring 40 big jugs of water and then fill them up. And that's how they have their water. That's amazing.
The third special ingredient.
What's the third special ingredient?
The garlic, obviously. Mm. Yeah. 30 minutes of slow boil. Let's add some pepper in it. Some garlic in a second. The Hungarian will kill me for bringing this in. But we are Romanians and we adapt, right? This is the Romanian goulash.
I love it, man.
Yeah. Almost getting there, getting there. Like 10 minutes, maybe.
It looks spice, like when you see all that pepper like rising to the top. Like,
isn't it? Huh?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Whoa, look at that.
Look at that.
All right, guys. Now dig in. Taste. Taste.
Time to taste. Taste yeah. The test.
Exactly.
Okay,
yeah, yeah,
potato,
try. Yeah,
meat.
And some meat, and a bit of, yeah.
Okay, mm. Let's
The smell is amazing.
It's a bit of more salt.
Tommy, gosh. It's so freaking good.
The
good.
Meat is so tender and juicy.
Mm-hmm. That's the idea behind.
Not dry, the potatoes, perfectly soft.
Attractive.
Not overly soft.
Mm-mm.
The sauce, peppery, seasoned well.
Perfect touch.
Really?
Melinda, how are you doing over there? I'm ready to eat.
Come in.
Yeah.
You know?
No,
don't do that.
No, come on. Here, let me cozy, hearty, home-cooked, made with love, fresh ingredients.
The key is made with love.
Yes. Also, but like, it's raining and we're having like the goulash. It's like the perfect combination. It's just all like working out so well.
Yeah.
Come on, look like you're working harder.
The old way, like our ancestors used to eat bread
in
the wilderness.
Yeah. Got water, we got beer, we got wine.
Wow.
And a homemade liquor.
Wow.
Fenting Romanian drink.
Yeah, they are not letting Tommy go thirsty, that is for sure.
No or doubt,
moving, but
no
just,
doubt.
Like, a little slower pace. Ooh, that's
fancy. The meal is ready.
Thank you.
Very well. Some polenta?
Yes, please.
This is a...
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Bread on top.
Look.
Yeah, that's the first dish.
Well done. Bravo, bravo, bravo to the chef. Hey,
very well.
Well done.
Eating it with my eyes first looks absolutely spectacular.
How beautiful is that?
Yes. Oh, okay. Mm. See you guys at the table.
Very well.
Perfect.
Of course.
I'll never say no to polenta.
A little bit?
Okay.
I'm the baby. This dish is absolutely incredible. The pork is so tender, falls apart. The polenta is perfectly cooked. It's cheesy. They pair together so well.
Oh yes.
Thank you guys so much for it. Amazing.
Really happy to have you here, guys.
Thank you so much.
Really
seriously, thank you.
You
guys are so spoiled. You get this great food all the time, don't you?
You just love it?
Obviously.
Wow. I gotta say.
All I can say is thank you. Yeah. It's amazing. Hungarians don't come for us, but the garlic, the garlic was a good choice. I can taste it.
You can feel it because
yeah.
It was added at the end of the cooking process.
It didn't have time to get bitter and not
No, exactly. It's not disappearing in the in your food, but it stays on top of the flavors, you know? Because you gotta have something that makes the flavor of the food, right?
Yeah.
And that's the garlic that sits on top of it and it's
Yeah, that's true. What happened to your dish?
It's gone.
Thank you.
Yeah, you are
really
so sweet.
Appreciate it. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was great.
Thank you so much
with us. It was a really great experience.
Oh, thank you, my man. Thank you, Kiel, from you.
Yes.
Thank you. Well, you guys, thank you so much for everything. It was amazing evening.
It was.
Dude, it was so fun.
Yeah, great experience.
Yeah, you're a good dog. Dog, Rondo. You're just a good dog.
Yeah. Bye. Enjoy your evening, you guys. Thank you.
You too. Bye, guys.
Wow, what an incredible day. I don't think we could have ever expected it to go as well as it did. We made new friends, ate some really great food, had a great time. Overall, just a top-notch day. So hope you guys enjoyed it, and we will see you guys in the next one.